Hello everyone, here today discuss about BIOS. Here you see in the market BIOS IC available 8 leg IC, 32 leg IC, 48 leg IC, 42 leg IC. Here I'll show you BIOS. This is the PDIP IC, it will use on desktop motherboard, and SOIC. This also used in laptop motherboard and desktop motherboards, and PLCC. It has 32 leg IC, and SOIC. It has 8 leg. PDIP. It has also 8 leg IC. This IC, deep IC, deep socket IC. This is SOIC. It has legs and. This PLCC IC, socket IC, we call socket IC. Here we fix this IC on the board also, and this IC we fix on socket. Now in the present market, laptop motherboards and desktop motherboards have SOIC available. This type of ICs you see everywhere. Here I have one motherboard. It is CQ42. Here I will show you. This is BIOS IC. This one. And this motherboard have ICH and GMCH IC. ICH and GMCH IC present on the board, and sometimes here we see only one BIOS present on this board. Here only one BIOS IC present. Some kind of motherboard you see which is have a PCH IC. It has two BIOS ICs, like one was EC BIOS and second one is a system BIOS. EC BIOS always connect with IO ICs, and system BIOS connect with PCH. Now EC BIOS embedded controller, which is control to your IO. And system BIOS, it's for display only. That's why if your motherboard is in dead condition or charging problem condition, now you do work. If problem is in your BIOS, you need to do work on EC BIOS, not the system BIOS. Okay, now here I'll show you. Pin details. BIOS pin details. When you see the BIOS IC on the board, it has 8 leg IC present. Now pin number 1 is CS hash pin, and pin number 2 is SO, system output pin. White pin WP, write protect. GND ground pin, pin number 4, SI pin, system input pin, pin number 5, clock, pin number 6, and hold key is pin number 7, and VCC pin number 8. Now if you need to check BIOS, it was faulty or good condition, or it will work or not, now you need to check pin number VCC pin, pin number 8, because this is main input volts pin, voltage collector to collector pin. Here we need input volts, 3.3 volt. Now I have one motherboard. This motherboard has dead condition. Now I'll show you how to check voltages and signals on it. I plug adapter over here. Now I'll show you. First I'll show you with the multimeter. If you need to conformly check BIOS, you should check with oscilloscope. But here I'll show you what is the difference. Just look at over here. I'll check pin number 8. Pin number 8, VCC pin. Here I need to check 3.3 volt. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You always count anti-clockwise numbers. Here, this is the pin number 8. Yeah. Here we get 3.3 volts on pin number 8, VCC pin. Now, you need to check pin number 7 also. It has also same voltages. 3.3 volt, yes, 3.3 volt, and you need to check this pin number 3, right protect pin. Here also we need 3.3 volt, pin number 3. If you not receive this signal on pin numbers 8, VCC volt, that time your BIOS IC is not working, and that time your laptop motherboard is in on dead condition. That's why these three voltages are required on the BIOS LEDs, pin number 3, pin number 7 and pin number 8. It was necessary, otherwise it will not work. Now then after when you receive these three voltages on the BIOS IC. Now then after you check signal input pin. So this is actually data input pin which will come from your IOIC and clock. Pin number 6. Clock. Pin number 6. This clock also come from IOIC. Now here we check. If we check, because clock and data always we need to check with the oscilloscope, not through the multimeter. But I'll show you, this is not actual testing. If you need to check, look at over here, no any kind of data. Now here you check pin number, I'll check here pin number 6, no voltages, and clock. Here I'll check clock, pin number 5. Yeah, here voltages, but we are not sure clock is coming or not. So that's why we need oscilloscope. But and here we check pin number 2 also, signal output pin, pin number 2. I'll check here pin number 2. This is pin number 2. Here I get 3.3 volts. On pin number 2, but we are not sure this BIOS working or not, inside file are fine or not, so we need oscilloscope. I'll show you how to check. I connect. Here I connect on the ground and this pin I'll set on 10x. Now here I put on pin number 6. Yes. Now I'll check. Look, I'll check on pin number 6. No, sorry, pin number 5. Okay, here I'll check clock. This is the clock signal. Look, I'll show you. This is BIOS IC. I'll check here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Pin number 6. Clock. Look at the signal and I'll show you frequency also. Look, 16.67 megahertz. Frequency 16.67 megahertz. It will comes from IOIC. It means IO give proper clock on the BIOS, and here we check data. Look at data. This is data. This also comes from IOIC. This is the data signal. This. Now I'll check pin number 2 signal output. On pin number 2. No signal, nothing. It means here we does not get any kind of signal on pin number 2. This pin number is output pin. Here we check our BIOS IC working or not, inside file working or not. Now here on pin number 2, here I am not getting any kind of volts or signals. Look, here we could not see any kind of signal, and even though here we cannot get any kind of frequencies, look, nothing. It means this BIOS not functioning properly. Now I'll show you something. Look, this laptop motherboard is in dead condition. I'll show you here. Here we get voltages on on-off trigger switch. Look, 3.3 volt here I'll get, but when I short this legs, motherboard not get it on. I'll show you. I press trigger, it will get trigger but not on. Zero. After trigger zero, or again 3.3 volt. So here our motherboard is in dead condition, and here I'll measure BIOS not working fine. Now so what we need to do, here we need to know the BIOS, which BIOS file required to this motherboard. Now every laptop motherboard, when you see the bottom casing inside back side, there was a written model. I'll show you. Look over here, on this laptop Pavilion G6. This laptop is Pavilion G6, and when you see bottom side, there is written series G6 model, which series motherboard this. So how do you check? Go. This motherboard is a CQ42116TU. Now here I'll go to support site and search BIOS update file. Now here I'll type CQ42 and you see lot of models available over here. CQ42 200, it means CQ42 model 200 series. Now this is 200 220 TU 224 TU 227 TU, but all are CQ40. Here also see you CQ42 300 series 307 355 356 TU, and here you see CQ42 400 series CQ42 100 series. Yes, here our motherboard C100 series, this motherboard is in 100 series. Now here compact Presario CQ42 116 TU, this model is this motherboard. Now open, select operating system. Here find BIOS. Here is it, BIOS download, save. And I'll show you one more thing. BIOS file downloading. Okay. Now file is here, open. This is the file. Now here okay, when you get this exe file, then after this is the file, some kind of exe file does not properly protected, that's why when you click, left click on it and extract here, some kind of extractors available. You use WinRAR, 7-Zip or Universal Extractor. Now here I'll extract this Now here you see FD format. Before here here you see BIOS IC for BIOS file for extraction, FD format dot FD. FD format dot bio format dot ROM format dot hex format dot bin format. This is the format, different kind of formats available for file format. Now you program it any file, if any kind of formats available, when you extract over here, here I extract this exe file, here I'll get lot of files. How do you know which file is for BIOS only? Now here you check formats, extension name. These are extension names. This is the extension names, FD, bio, dot ROM, dot hex, dot bin. This is the extension. With the help of this extension name, you find the actual file, which one is the BIOS file. Now here when you see, this is the FD format dot FD, extension name dot FD. Here is also extension name FD, and here is also extension name FD. It means inside this exe file, three different kind of BIOS file available. Now which one is our BIOS file? Now this file size is 4.5 MB, and this file size 1 MB, and this file size is 2 MB. Now what you need to do, first you remove the BIOS IC on the board, and then after you get backup on this file, and you check which file size present on this, inside this BIOS IC. Then after you decide which file you need, 1 MB, 2 MB or 1 MB or 4 MB. Now here first I remove this BIOS IC, and then after I program with one file. Then after we check our motherboard working fine or not. Now here we remove BIOS related faults. We see lot of different kind of faults related to BIOS, like this. Here we see dead condition, and sometime laptop motherboard is in a no charging problem also. Your laptop does not charge battery, that time fault is in BIOS also. Now I remove this IC. Okay. I remove this. This is our PA BIOS programmer TL-866. have fixed this. Okay, now I connect BIOS IC onto the programmer. Now I need to program this IC. This is the software. Now here you see this BIOS programmer have good facility for auto which is auto detection. No need to read the number, just you go over here auto 25 select. This facility is for just only 8 leg IC and 16 leg IC. Now you see here I connect, detect this list are coming. Now this is our SOIC, that's why here we select Micronics KH25L8005 SOIC N8 here and select. Okay, now we need to get backup, that's why we need to read this, read chip. Okay, now I'll save this on desktop. HP CQ42 save. This format, look here, this is the bin format dot bin, HP CQ42 dot bin format. It will save in bin format. Okay, now here I'll show you. This is our backup, HP CQ42. Okay, now we need to program it, that's why I choose a file, open file. Here is our file. Now I select 1 MB file first because it has ICH and GMCH, and if this dual core type module present, now it has a low size BIOS, that's why I use a lowest one first. Now I'll program it. One more thing, I'll tell you this. When you check Dell and HP, which one use this type of connector, which one have a adapter detection signal, when you plug here, one light glow over here, it means your BIOS is working fine. When you plug this and this LED when glow, it means your BIOS, EC BIOS walking. But when you not get this LED, it means maybe problem is in your EC BIOS. That's why here you not get a adapter detection signal. Okay, here our BIOS programmed. Now here we remove this IC and then after we fix it back again. Okay, now I fix this IC and here we check again voltages first. What was the difference after doing programming? Yeah, here before program here we get zero, nothing on pin number 5 data, and pin number 6, let's check pin number 6 same voltage 1.4, and let's see pin number 2. Yeah, here we get 1.5 volt. Before doing BIOS programming here we get 3.3 volts, but after BIOS programming here we get 1.5 volt. Now let's see what was the change in our oscilloscope. here I'll check first on pin number 5, data, look at data. This is the data signal. Look at the data. Always when you check on pin number 5, look over here. This signal looks like M. This data. Look, M shape. This is the data signal, and here you see data coming, and parameters. Here you check. Here you see signal frequency also, and here we check pin number 6, clock. Now here you see clock cycle. This is the proper clock cycle. Here you see frequency 32, 44, 42, 41, 42 megahertz frequency present on the clock pin number 6. Now we check pin number 2, output. Here we get output or not? Oh wow, look, here you see data and clock, both are mixed, and here we get both signal, data and clock mix output over here. Look, same data here we also get. Look, look at the signal. Now here we check it was get it on or not. Here we get 3.3 volt on off switch. And yes, it was started. Now if you need to check display, it was coming or not. Now, and suppose you does not have a LCD screen, so here you check on pin LVDS connector. You check here LCD VDD signal, it will come or not, 3.3 volt. If this LCD VDD volt come onto the LVDS connector, it means definitely display will be come. Now this is the way to do reprogram the BIOS, and I'll show you more things here. How to break password. Thank you. Okay, now here we discuss about BIOS password break. How to break a BIOS password. Here we see different password stored in system, like BIOS password, SDD password, system password, three different kind of password installed in system. Now for system password, easily remove for formatting and for softwares and some commands. Now if you forget the BIOS password, now how we recover it and how it will break? Now here we discuss, if you not get hash code, some kind of motherboards, when you put wrong password on the BIOS, now it will generate hash code. Some different motherboard, different models generate different kind of hash codes. Which one look like this? This type of hash codes generate by the BIOS. This type different hash codes generate by the BIOS. Here I will show you. This is Chipronic website. Here you search BIOS password removal toolkits also. Here you see this type of hash control codes, system disabled, and this is your hash code. Now with the help of this hash code,